people's eyes as a legend, an icon. So, welcome back to Scala Radio, Midge. Hello.
Hey, how are you doing?
Well, it is lovely to have you back on Scala. You know, you did a fantastic show for us. It was brilliant, but you've been busy, haven't you? It's a big year for you.
It's been a strange one. The last 3 years has been a bit odd because of all the lockdown and stuff, and you know, many times postponed touring. You know, for a while I had a distinct feeling it was never going to go back to how it was, if anywhere near that. So I finally this year got a tour that was due to go out in 2020. I finally got the tour of the UK done this year. And that's kept me incredibly busy. And then, of course, I've got a significant birthday coming up soon, so I couldn't let that slip past without doing something. I mean, what does a musician do on his birthday besides eat too much cake and drink too much champagne? You get on stage and you go and do something. That's what you do.
You know, it's very rude to ask people their age. But it's a big year. It is rude. But I'm not going to say anything unless you do.
I still find it hard to say. I have to say, we've just announced this special show at the Royal Albert Hall in London, and I couldn't actually type the words and I couldn't say the words. So we've said to celebrate 7 decades of a life of music. So yeah, I have a significant birthday coming up in October,
so that's 50 years of music.
Yes, thank you. It's easier to say that.
Yeah, yeah. So I just do that. Yeah,
15 a little bit, and I didn't think it was going to happen either because of all the lockdowns and stuff. The Royal Albert Hall and all the big significant venues are all booked up for years until last month, and all of a sudden a date came free just before my birthday, and we thought we're going to go for that.
I mean, it's so exciting. I've just got goosebumps. It's meant to be, and it's going to be exciting. So celebrating 7 decades, a life in music, to celebrate you and everything that you have given to the music industry. So let's talk about the concert, special guests, what we're going to hear. Well, I'm saying it as if I'm going to be there.
Well, you're saying it as if I'm going to be there. I mean, right now I have a blank canvas because literally it was 3 or 4 weeks ago that this date appeared. So we've gone for the date and we've told people about it, and they're very excited. They've got people coming in from all over the world, which is wonderful. I mean, it's amazing to come and celebrate my birthday. But right now, it really is a blank canvas. When you do a concert like this, you tend to go two ways, one of two ways. And one is, you know, just go out and do what you can do best. And the other is to throw the kitchen sink at it. So, you know, you use the organ, you've got a choir, you've got an orchestra, you've got everyone that's ever been on stage with you ever, you know, all lined up, ready to come on, like waiting in a doctor's waiting room. You know, you're next, come on, let's go and sing something. You know, and I'm kind of loath to do that. So right now, it's still formulating itself in my head.
Oh, I love what you've done there. You've not committed to anything. Because I suppose
I'm not committed to absolutely. That was a political answer.
I was done with skill and stealth.
I should have started it with, let me just say this, and then not answered your question at all, like most politicians do.
Well, I think that's good. Keep everyone on their toes. Remind everyone about the date.
It's the 4th of October. Which we were very lucky to get. The birthday is actually on the 10th. So, yeah, it's very, very timely, as you say, and we're very lucky for it to come.
It's going to be incredible. Now, Midge, we're going to chat classical music in just a tick, but before we do that, we've asked you to pick something for us to hear right now. So what is choice number one?
Well, I got a bit of an education doing my slot on Scala, because I was discovering artists that I'd never heard of before, and I fell in love with a lot of these artists, including this guy. It's Max Richter and on The Nature of Daylight.
Great track. I interviewed him on the show a few months back, and he is insane, just like you are. Let's have a listen.
I love the fact that he's a neoclassical composer, but he has a room full of synthesizers. He could have been an Ultravox. You know, there we go.
Max Richter's On the Nature of Daylight, chosen by my special guest here on Scala today, the incredible Midge. I've just been just saying amazing things about you today. So when you're trying to relax, what do you like to listen to?
I do listen to a lot of instrumental music. I listen to the people I've always listened to. I think you become attached to a certain type of style that artists and writers have.
So what sort of music is that? What do you?
Well, there can be anything. I mean, I'm still a massive Kate Bush fan, or Peter Gabriel, or everyone was a fan of David Bowie. Every musician on the planet owes a nod of gratitude to David Bowie, because he broke the rules. Sometimes you just need that feeling of companionship, and music does that. Yes. Music gives you that. It's like a cuddle, you know. If you're sitting on your own and you want to be, you know, embraced, and there's no one around you, music will do that.
100%. Although you've just given me an idea, I'm thinking Kate Bush, Peter Gabriel on the lineup.
Now, wouldn't that be something? Yes, but they're more recluses than I am, so it's gonna be very difficult.
I think they'd come out just for you.
You think?
Yes. Let's make it
happen.
Wouldn't
that be lovely?
Well, the other thing I was going to ask you, there's so much I wanted to ask you, because you're sitting in a music room. For anyone just listening, Midge is sitting, there's a keyboard next to him. He's got a, you know, nice, comfortable chair. He looks like he's ready to compose. Is that something you're doing? You know, talk about music now and how it's relevant to you.
Music's always relevant. If you're a musician, having a little studio, which now consists of a small computer and a bit of software and a keyboard and a guitar or whatever, you're as limited as your imagination. You can do professional recordings, whatever you happen to be. So for me, constantly writing music, not necessarily for release, but just as a release for me to get things out my system, it's just a great thing. You know, if I didn't have the music, I'd be lying on some therapist's couch somewhere, spouting off about my life. Yeah. Music's a wonderful way of channeling, you know, all those emotions and feelings and doubts that you have, that we all have. And I'm just lucky enough that I'm able to channel it all down and put it into a song or a piece of music.
And I think that taps into a lot of what people are saying now. It's finding something that means something to you, that gives you that cuddle, you say, that you're passionate about, that can help you and, you know, fill a void. And
very much so. Yeah. Very much so. I mean, I suppose with the advent of the internet and stuff, you get people writing to you who tell you the most bizarre things about, you know, there was a doctor in Paris wrote to me and said that he was from the Lebanon, and in order to get away from the bombs and the fighting and stuff that was going on, he used to put his old Walkman on and play some Ultravox stuff, which I'm not convinced that was any better than what he was hearing outside, but it made something fabulous for him. It took him out of the reality of where he was, and music does that. Yeah. You don't have to be in something extreme to be able to do that. Music is something that you just, you know, you stick on your headphones and you just lose yourself for that hour or whatever that you want to indulge in.
100%. And I think you're so humble and you downplay the impact your music has had on so many people. And that's what that guy, you know, he wrote to you because he felt that impact of your music. So don't downplay it, because you are part of history and you've done an amazing thing. And this year is a wonderful year for you. So own it.
I shall. I have been well and truly chastised. So I will get off my humble soapbox and say, yes, I deserve everything.
Exactly. And on that note, you've got something else to do. Tell us what song you've chosen to see this wonderful interview out.
Melody to me is all important, you know, much more so than lyrics. I think you can express an awful lot in melody. And this piece, which I probably heard on the radio when I was a kid, not knowing what it was at all, still gets me to this day. It's Bach's Sheep May Softly Graze.
It's a great one to end on. Thank you so much, Midge, for being my guest today.
Absolute pleasure, and thanks for having me.
Not at all.